My name is Grant Rowe, and I'm Respiratory Protection Product Line Manager with Bullard. Today I'd like to share with you about our Spectrum Series supplied air respirator and continuous flow operation. While the Spectrum can be configured in other respiratory modes, such as powered air purifying respirator, pressure demand, and pressure demand escape, the most commonly used mode is continuous flow, especially with our free air pumps. Continuous flow simply means that there is continuous supply of grade D breathable air flowing to the respirator. That grade D breathable air may come from ambient air pumps, such as our free air pumps, may come from a compressor with appropriate filtration, or may come from a compressed air bottle. Common applications for the Spectrum in continuous flow mode include spray painting, remediation, such as with asbestos, mold, or nuclear, and spray foam insulation. Now let's get acquainted with the respirator components. First, we have the full face mask. It has a polycarbonate lens rated for ANSI, ISCA, Z87 Plus impact face protection. This lens provides a large field of view that is also optically correct and won't cause distortion. Lens covers are available to protect and prolong the life of the lens. Next, we have the silicone double flange, which seals onto the face. The mask is secured by this silicone head strap with 5 adjustable buckles and slides. Inside the mask, we have a nose cup, which helps prevent fogging of the lens by the exhaled air. On the outside of the mask, we have a speaker diaphragm, which improves communication, and this is protected by the mask cover. Below this is the air entryway where the breathing tube threads in. The breathing tube comes with a waist belt and an integrated flow control valve with nipple for air supply hose connection. Finally, the air supply hose can be configured in multiple lengths up to 300 feet. V20 series air supply hose is 1/2 inch inside diameter for use with the low pressure requirements of the free air pumps, while V10 series air supply hose is 3/8 inch inside diameter for use with traditional compressors. Now that you've familiarized yourself with your respirator, let's prepare it for use. Remember, before donning, respirators should only be used as part of a written and comprehensive OSHA-compliant respirator protection program as outlined in 29 CFR 1910.134. Any employee who will wear a respirator must undergo a medical evaluation. Employees must pass a fit test before wearing a tight-fitting mask-style respirator, such as the Spectrum Series. Facial hair in the area of the mask seal is not permitted. For a complete listing of all warnings and cautions, please consult your Spectrum user manual. After unpackaging your respirator, release the head straps to the full outward position by lifting the quick release tabs. Insert your chin into the bottom of the face piece and pull the head straps over your head. Adjust the right and left lower straps simultaneously until secure and comfortable. Repeat this for the right and left upper straps. Finally, adjust the top head strap until secure and comfortable. Next, conduct a negative pressure seal check. Do this by inhaling until the mask collapses slightly and hold your breath for 5 seconds. If no leakage is detected, then the test is successful. If the mask doesn't collapse or a leakage is detected, then readjust or try another size and repeat. Temporarily remove the mask by releasing the head straps. Attach the breathing tube to the face piece by threading until finger tight. Buckle the belt to your waist and adjust as necessary. Then attach the female end of the air supply hose to the nipple of the flow control device. Then attach the other end of the air supply hose to the breathing air source. Adjust the pressure to the requirements listed in the user instruction manual. You are now ready to work while wearing the Spectrum Series Continuous Flow Respirator. To doff the Spectrum Continuous Flow Respirator, Leave the work area with air still flowing to the respirator. Then simply loosen the head straps by lifting the quick release tabs and remove the mask. And now we will cover inspection, cleaning, and storage of your Spectrum Series respirator. All components should be inspected for damage or excessive wear before and after each use. Clean and sanitize between each use. The mask may be immersed in warm water, approximately 120 degrees Fahrenheit, with mild detergent or a germicide. The respirator body may be scrubbed gently with a cloth or soft brush. Mineral spirits and mild solvents may be used, but do not use volatile solvents or harsh cleaning agents as they can damage the respirator components and compromise protection. Rinse the mask assembly in clean, warm water. Allow to air dry away from direct heat and sunlight. The breathing tube may be hand sponged, but not immersed. Again, do not use harsh cleaning agents. The air supply hose should be hand sponged with warm water and mild detergent. Rinse, allow to air dry, and inspect. When all components have been thoroughly cleaned, dried, and inspected, they should be stored with protection from contamination, sunlight, and extreme temperature. For more information, please consult your user manual or contact Bullard by calling 877-BULLARD or by emailing info@bullard.com.